do. 10 days have passed since that terrible accident. But I only found you the day before yesterday. You were lying in the snow, and I brought you here. You've been asleep for 2 days, you know. I just can't figure it out. How did you manage to stay alive for 8 days? Looks like you were eating regularly, too. So strange. I found you pretty far away from the crash site. Do you remember anything? I see. I'm Kimberly. Kimberly Fox. I'll talk to you more later. You must be tired. Seems like you were having a lot of nightmares, too.
Survivors of that plane crash. Are you hurt?
Don't touch me. Get out of here.
Just a minute. What do you think you're doing?
Get the hell out of here.
Wait. I haven't blossomed yet.
Blossomed?
Come on. Didn't it look like flowers were blooming from that monster? You both saw it, and there's more just like it out there. He's not the only one.
What exactly was that thing?
Who the hell knows? Some of them look like they might have been passengers from the crash. But the monsters got to them. And as you can see, they turn into...
Monsters?
Yeah. They blossom. They've turned into monsters, too.
Get out.
Look, like I said...
I'll shoot. I swear I'll shoot.
Look, unless we work together, we won't get out of here alive.
I will shoot.
All right, I'll go.
Now.
All right. I get it. But listen up. And listen good. You may be armed. But there's only one way to tell whether someone's human or not. And that's by the color of their blood. Those things bleed green. But to see any blood, you've got no choice but to shoot. And you've got to do it fast because they'll be on you in a flash. We don't know much of anything yet. Should we shoot everything that looks like this creature? And what if it looks human and bleeds green? There may be monsters that bleed red for all we know. What are we supposed to do then? We don't know whether everything that looks like a monster always has green blood. Maybe some are still human inside. Maybe they can revert back to humans again. We don't have any answers. All I can say is, survive. Get out of this godforsaken place alive. Be careful, both of you. Watch your back.
I'm sorry. I wish... if I could... Damn it. Everyone who survived feels that way. They had no idea what to do. Maybe you're better off than others, not remembering anything. Hey, do you remember anything? Anything about Janny? Janny! The little girl I found you with. You were both lying there. In the snow, and you were trying to protect her. Oh, I brought you both back here, but she wandered off when I wasn't looking. She may know something about you, and she may still be around here, just hiding. Maybe you could take a look outside. You won't be able to walk too far in the snow, and the area is surrounded by forest and a sheer drop, but I'll wait here. Be careful, okay? Danny was with you the whole time. Well, I'm sure it'll come back to you in time. Be careful out there. First. But you know, I spoke with this Norwegian hunter in a tavern, and he said even rabbits and mice have killer instinct, and that there's no such thing in this world as absolute prey or an absolute predator. He also said that it's an energy, kind of a focused awareness that binds life together. So I guess we better stay on our guard at all times to survive. To feed the flame of instinct with the fuel of life, was the way he put it. The reason why consuming meat gives the body strength is because the urge to kill and the energy of life embodies the flesh. Or something like that. Well, I guess what I'm trying to tell you is to eat a lot and get better soon. Come on, aim straight and take a shot. You got it. Shoot that way. There's two more over there. You're way better than me. I think you've got what it takes to be a great hunter. You can put the game you caught in this portable cooker. It automatically cleans and cooks the meat. So you can eat whenever you're hungry. It's pretty good. much better than stale bread. I'm gonna go get a little rest now. Monster got me. I just need to rest a bit. I'm thinking about how we can get out of here. Could you look for Jenny?
Thank you.
you didn't find Jenny. Where could she be? There's nothing else around here except the stone hut. And I already looked there. There's the crash site, but I don't think you should go there. There's only... You'll only see things of the brutal aftermath. The snow must have given those poor people a proper burial by now. If you are going to the stone hut, use this key to open the cabinet inside. I locked it because I didn't want the monsters to get any of the weapons in there. Be careful. I'm tired. I'm gonna rest a little bit longer. bit better. Looks like you've been to the stone hut. What's that? Brought the radio back. It won't work, you know. I try to get the news through the radio, but we're too high up for that. A newsflash from the world of the living won't do as much good anyway. But you know what? I got an idea. I think there's something here that we could both use. Want to hear it? It's called... Counting the Roses. I actually wrote the lyrics, believe it or not. I'm a poet. Someone who happened to read a poem of mine wrote and recorded this tune. I even got a letter once from someone who heard the song. Poetry to me, it's like creating my own microcosm. A sanctuary of comfort. It was probably, no, it must have been the end of another sad day when I wrote this poem. I saw this place. It was pure white, as far as the eye could see. And I was counting roses. There's yellow and red and lavender. Hundreds of roses, so beautiful. You could lose yourself in them. Listen to the radio, and now we have no tape player. Here, you can have it. Consider it a gift. A broken tape player and a pulverized poem of mine. How depressing. And I thought a little music would be good for our morale. It's been 10 days since the accident. So why hasn't any help arrived? Can you remember anything? I mean, anything at all from the last 8 days? You must have been with someone else. I couldn't make it out, but you were calling someone's name. I wonder what could have happened to Jenny. If we can only find her, you know, she might know about this other person. I'm sure of it. I can take care of myself. I just wonder how we're gonna get out of here.
Thank you. Mission is about Canada from the Prialis star cluster on red high-heel shoes. The Turbulence is the original ETA at St. Charles. Autopilot engaged
in the galley right on schedule.
Snowmobile. I bet we can make it out of here as long as we have that. I don't think the monsters can attack us while we're riding a snowmobile. But we don't have much gas left. Just enough to get back to the cabin. Yeah, we'll need to find some gasoline somewhere before we can go anywhere else. Let's just go back for now. It's not much, but our luck is finally beginning to turn for the better. Right? Laura? Surprised? You never told me your name. But that must be your name. This is yours, isn't it? I found it by the bed. It's engraved, "To Laura from your mother Lucy." Does that bring anything back? Lucy. That's your mother's name. Does it ring any bells? Can you remember? Can you remember her? What's she like? What does she look like? I bet she was very kind to you. When I found you lying in the snow, you were holding it as if it were so precious. During those 2 days, you were unconscious. You held this close and kept calling out someone's name. A man's name. Laura? Laura? Laura, are you all right? Laura!
Laura. Laura. Are you all right? I'm glad you came too. Here you are. You don't want to lose it. It's a precious gift from your mother. Are you hurt? You don't seem to have any serious injuries. You should be on your feet in no time. Do you remember the plane crash? Our plane went down after being hit by a meteorite. The strange thing is, your compact started to glow just moments before impact. And I had a vision of a burning rock colliding with the jet. Without thinking, I grabbed your arm, and the next thing I knew, we were on this mountain. I managed to carry you down to this small cabin. You remember me, don't you? I'm David. David Brenner.
You would sleep for another 2 days straight. I was just getting used to having a friend. Don't leave me alone again, okay? Come on, let's go back to the cabin. Who knows? Maybe we'll find Janny fast asleep in bed. Possible friend gained in the worst possible circumstance. I'm feeling much better, thanks to you. I've gone to look for gas, hoping that you will recall your past. Very, very soon, Kimberly.